get ready to match the stars. Gary Berghoff, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Pat Crowley, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Dulabont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Roberts.
Johnny Olson and friends.
You make a lovely hood ornament.
I'm a figurehead. In case some of you are saying,
I thought you were the angel or the fairy on top of the tree.
You're a fine figure of a head.
No, it didn't really. I just wanted to point out, they say, hey, that girl looks familiar. Said, that's What's-Her-Name, isn't it? It's not What's-Her-Name, it's Pat Crowley, who many of you remember from Please Don't Eat the Daisies.
Oh, my goodness.
Who's now seen on Steve Forrest, Joe Forrester.
Thank you.
Joe Forrester.
Thank you so much.
And up here is What's-His-Name, you know. You see him on MASH all the time, don't you? He plays Radar.
Crowley, yeah.
And now on Tuesday nights on CBS, right?
That's correct, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Now, if you're all quite ready, let's say hello to Carol Fisher and Jack Butts.
Yay!
Yay! Hello, Carol. Now, we have here a real champ. She's won $6,200, and she's ready to have another go at it here. And Jack Butts, we found out a little bit about him. He owns a motel in Encino. And he's been doing that for the last 15 years or so.
That's right.
And he looks like a jolly fellow. He wouldn't holler at you if you were trying to sneak in late at night or something like that. Now, Jack, you had your first round question. You didn't score any celebrity matches at all.
Unfortunately.
Your question will come along in a moment or so. See how you do. But right now, let's see about this. Pay attention and hurry right back. Okay, now, here we go. Next, all right. Here we are. This is yours, Carol. Pay attention. When George hitchhikes, he doesn't use his hands. He doesn't need to. George has a giant thumb where his blank ought to be.
I didn't do it.
He has a giant thumb where his what ought to be?
He has a giant thumb where his blank ought to be.
Where his blank ought to be.
Yeah. Giant thumb where his blank ought to be. See that? He doesn't use his hands. He doesn't need to. George has a giant thumb where his blank ought to be.
Right.
Got the idea. Terrific. Come on, because so first you tell you're right-handed. You put that in your right hand. And now you write something.
You know,
what?
I'm not saying that Jack Butts is related to Earl Butts, but have you heard about that? Have you heard about that new weed deal to Encino?
No.
Yes.
Really? Uh-huh. Come on, put something down there now.
Do you?
No, of course not. Here we go. Now we call on Carol Fisher. When George hitchhikes, he doesn't use his hands. He doesn't need to. George has a giant thumb where his blank ought to be.
Don't holler at me.
Don't holler at you?
Nose.
Nose! That's very good. She said nose, right?
The only trouble is he has to keep his hands in his pocket so he won't smell the smog. I said nose, too.
Nose! That's one for Carol. What do you say?
I say that Charles Nelson Reilly thinks he's the only one who's clever as an artiste.
Yeah.
I said nose, and I drew a nice little picture.
Oh, isn't that clever? Now, did you understand the question?
Oh, did he understand the question?
Of course okay. I understand the question. But it's difficult because I said nose, too, but when he, you know, but then he blows his fingers, which is a very
tough. Yeah, it's very tough. Uh-huh. All right. Okay. Hello there. Here's what's her name. Let's see what answer she had there.
Well, I just am getting into the swing of things, and I put Fanny down, which is
what. Oh, Fanny, yes. That's interesting, isn't
it? I thought that was a nice
picture.
Didn't know
if he was coming or going.
On the highway.
How about that? Going my way, sir? Nobody can go that way. Richard?
The nose habit.
The nose habit. There, that's four for Carol. Joyce?
I don't know.
He has a giant thumb where his blank ought to be.
Because he didn't have hands, I thought it was his elbow, and he just go like that.
joke.
Elbow.
Says elbow.
Yeah, you know, you just...
Boy, you
put her
really...
Back in the home.
Back in the home is where she is going. That's four for you, Carol. Now we go to round two and ask Jack to make his selection.
I'll take B again.
B, all right. Jack, everybody plays for Jack because he didn't match him, buddy, the first time.
Never you mind, Jack.
Let's see how he does this time. Listen carefully now. Charlie the Cannibal has good manners. Before he eats you, he says blank. Charlie the Cannibal has good manners. Before he eats you, he says blank.
Oh, sorry.
It's all right. Just fascinated by your response there. We call on Jack Butts. Everybody ready? Oh, Brett, are you still fooling around?
Wait a minute. Yes, dear. I'm not fooling around. I'm conscientiously trying to accomplish my job, which is what Goodson and Todd me pay me this fabulous salary.
Jack Butts. Charlie the Cannibal has good manners. Before he eats you, he says blank.
Grace.
Grace is a good answer, Jack. He gave the perfect answer. That boy gave the perfect answer, Gary.
But before he eats you, he'd say Gene, wouldn't he?
Oh, really?
let me see that last card again. from the last question. I said Grace.
Grace it is. There's one for Jack. Brett.
See, when you were shouting at me and telling me to hurry up, I was going to put Grace. I didn't know whether he was religious or not, but I put please, you see, instead, and it's your fault. And I'm sick of it, Gene.
Get out! Charles?
They always say grace at Mr. Butts' motel. When they check out that nobody got caught, I said grace.
Okay, two for you, Jack. All right. He's rolling along now, Pat.
I've got Bon Appetit.
Bon Appetit.
Yes,
all right. I got a match of two remaining ones to stay in the game, Jack. Let's see what happens here. Richard.
The old French cannibal gag, eh?
Yeah.
Bon Appetit. Put out a happy grave.
There it is. Three for you. We need one more to stay in the running. Yeah, right. It's up to you.
Where's your motel, Mr. Butts? Let's talk about the motel. No, the missionaries taught them it's okay to eat people as long as you say grace first.
Grace. Okay. So at this moment we have a tie, but you've got another shot at it here, and we'll see how this game turns out right after we see about this. Tie, 4-4. But she has one more shot at it because she hasn't had her second question. One to win, Carol.
These two lovely ladies will play frickin' frack.
Only two, right.
Just
the two. Everyone else was matched in the first round question. Now, since today is the 23rd of December, tomorrow naturally would be the 24th, which is Christmas Eve. So we got a little Christmas Eve type question for you. Quiet. Patrick hates Christmas. On Christmas Eve, Patrick climbs into his chimney and waits for Santa Claus. When Santa Claus slides down the chimney, Patrick blanks him. When Santa slides down the chimney, Patrick blanks him.
I don't have to be bothered with that question.
It's a guy who doesn't like Christmas. Yes.
You don't like Christmas.
He doesn't like Christmas, and he waits for Santa on Christmas Eve. He climbs right into the chimney. Then when Santa slides down the chimney, Patrick blanks him. All right, pop it into the slot there. And away we go. Off we go to Scotland Yard. All right. Carol Fisher. Patrick hates Christmas. On Christmas Eve, Patrick climbs into his chimney and waits for Santa Claus. When Santa slides down the chimney, Patrick blanks him.
I don't know.
He what?
You're going to have to be a little verbal, huh?
Yes. Well, now, wait a minute. If she can do it with sign language, that's perfectly all right. No, you got to say a word or words or whatever.
I guess pinches.
Pinches? Show us how you would pinch Santa Claus. Do it to Earl.
No.
Jack. No? Okay. All right, she says he pinches Santa Claus. Guy waits in the chair. What do you say there, my dear?
Well, I'd say he's so mean he belts him one.
He belts him one.
He hits him.
Oh, what do you say? Pinch your Santa Claus, what she's looking for.
I said it bites him on his blank.
Oh. Yeah, well, It felt like he pinched him. All right, now, so that ends that, and we got a 4-4 tie. We have to go to a tiebreaker, so we wipe this slate clean here, push this button, reveal two tie-breaking questions. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Jack, you make your selection.
I'll take B again.
B for butts. Here it is. Whoops, there it goes. There, where it is. Oh, there it is. There. Here it is. Jim said, what? Jim said, my blind date had rotten manners.
How rotten were they?
I'll tell you. She used the waiter's sleeve as a blank. My blind date had rotten manners. She used the waiter's sleeve as a blank. Good. Good, good, good. Three ready here, Brett. Come on, Brett, stop it.
I'm ready.
Okay.
Jackpot. Good gravy, Marie.
I'm ready.
Jim said my blind date had rotten manners. She used the waiter's sleeve as a...
napkin.
Napkin is his answer. What did you say, Jack?
I said napkin.
There's one for you, Jack. What do you say, Brett?
I say let's change motels and go to Jack's.
Okay, why not?
Because I said napkin.
Oh, that's sweet.
Maybe he'll give us a rate.
I bet he would. Charles?
I think this will make it possible now for Jack to give us the photographs he has. You know
what I mean. Three for you, Jack. All right, Pat.
Well, this makes it four for Jack.
Four for Jack.
First for me.
Jack is going like gangbusters here, Richard.
Good for Jack.
Are you going to break the magic spell?
Nope.
That's five. Now, Jack, this lady usually comes up with weird, incorrect answers. Now, let's see what she does this time. What,
gosh,
who me worry?
Five people said napkin?
Right.
Wouldn't it be awful if I didn't?
Yep.
I said it.
You said it. Okay. Well, you got your work cut out for you. Are you ready, Carol? All right, this is very important to Carol. Listen carefully, one and all. David's a little strange. He sent out, I'll tell you how strange he is, he sent out engraved invitations to his blank.
That's how strange
David is. He sent out engraved invitations to his blank. You're finished. Yes. Now, MASH is on Tuesday nights, right?
Yes.
Did I say that?
Thank you for mentioning that.
Lately? I've got to say that occasionally.
You said it at least 12 times in the last half hour.
Oh, I did. Yeah.
But thank you.
Yes. All right.
Wait a minute. Okay.
All
I
right.
got it. You said he was strange, right?
Carol Fisher, David's a little strange. He sent out engraved invitations to his...
funeral.
Funeral. Sounds like a good answer to me. Gotta have six funerals for her to stay in the game. Let's see if we get it from Gary.
That's right. She's got one.
She's got one. There's one for you, Carol. Brett?
But you said he was strange.
Strange, yes. Sent out engraved invitations to his funeral. That would be weird, wouldn't it?
I know, but I would send out engraved invitations to my funeral. I'm sorry, I said he sent out engraved invitations to his trial.
To his trial! So that means Jack Butts wins again. What the rest of you have? Stand there right on the adhesive tape there. You don't have to face me. Look at your public out there. There they are. They love you, Jack.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, Carol Fisher's going to be leaving us. I got to shake your hands because you love California now, right?
Yep.
And you're going to stay.
Yes.
And you're very happy out here.
I'm thrilled.
With the smog and all that, right? And you got $6,200. And our best wishes, Carol Fisher. Goodbye, my dear. While we're spinning her off, we're going to spin this message for you and then come back and see how Jack does. Now, Jack Butts here has done very well in winning a game and matching our celebrities. Now, Jack, we're going to see how good you are at second-guessing an entire studio audience as we go to the audience match. Are you ready for that?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. We polled one of those audiences recently, and we got their best response to this. Line blank. Now, the answer that that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it, Jack. Then, if you match the next one, the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250. And the third most frequently given response gets you $100. Now, we're going to ask some of our celebrities here to suggest some answers for you. It's up to you which ones you choose.
Richard?
Hi, how are you? Linebacker.
Linebacker. That's a football phrase.
Joyce?
Joyce?
I think lineman.
Lineman. All right. There's a song with that word.
Wichita Linebacker. Wichita
Linebacker. Linebacker. Yep. Linebacker. Right.
Brett.
Do you know, I know that none of you in all of America are going to believe that I had linebacker. I don't even know what kind of sport that is.
That's football.
Oh, good, but I did have it. Well, that's what I'm going to say. No.
It's been said.
I'm going to stick to it anyway.
She's thinking.
No, I'm going to say line drawings.
Line drawings.
Well, what would you say for number three if you're so smart? Oh, okay, I'll say line up.
Line up. Too late. We got lineman and linebacker. What do we got there? Line drawing? The first answer we have, so that's what
okay,
we have to go
on.
Line drawing. You want one of those?
Drawings.
Drawings.
I'll take linebacker.
Linebacker.
I would if I was you.
All right. We'll find out if linebacker is up there. All right, Jack, here we go. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Linebacker, you got it right off the bat. Congratulations, Jack. That means you're up to $200. You're going to play for 10 times 100 or 1,000. But first, let's find out what's under the 250. Line drive, a baseball term.
What does that mean? Tell me what that means.
Line drive is when you hit a low shot off the bat in baseball. It doesn't go high. It goes kind of straight. That's a line drive.
Oh, I hate those athletic questions.
All right. Let's see what's under the $500 response. Line up. Okay. Yeah. Well, now, Jack, you're going to play for 10 times 100 or 1,000, but to collect that, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly. That's the only way we can give you that $1,000. You've got to choose one celebrity now and see if you can get a little ESP going with that person.
I'll take Richard again.
Okay. All right, you stand right there. Here it is. It's worth $1,000. Richard, blank. Punishment. Blank punishment. Now he's finished. Now, we need an answer from you, Jack. What?
Capital punishment.
You didn't even wait for me to finish there. Capital punishment. He was very eager there, wasn't he? All right, he says capital punishment will match Richard for $1,000. You can look him right in the eye now if you want, Jack. He says capital punishment will match you so that he can collect $1,000.
I just finished a great book by a Russian author.
What's that called?
Crime and Punishment.
Crime and Punishment. Oh, is that what you wrote?
No, no, that's a capital offense.
Oh, I see. $1,200. Jack Butts here has $1,200. How do you feel, Jack?
I think I'm going to live.
Is it exciting?
Yes, it is.
Atta boy. Now, you want to meet another player?
Yes, I do.
Let's welcome Sandy Weinstein. Hello, Sandy. You know Jack? All right. Sandy, we welcome you.
Thank you.
Now, Leonard says... You know, I mean, are you Steenstein?
Stein.
Weinstein.
Yes.
Okay, I'm glad I got that part of it right. And tell us where you're from and all that.
Well, I'm originally from Chicago.
Yeah.
And I've been in California for 10 years.
You like it here?
I love it. I love California.
Okay.
I've been married for 12 years, and I have a beautiful little girl, Naomi, who is 9.
Naomi?
Yes.
That's Naomi. A pretty name.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And someone in your family named Naomi?
No.
No? Mm-mm. Just picked it out of a hat.
That's
huh?
We were watching a television show, and that's how we happened to.
Really?
The name. Mm-hmm.
Lucky you weren't watching Quick Drama.
Yes. I'd like you to meet my daughter, Kojak Weinstein. Okay. Well, Sandy, we wish you the best of luck. We've got to stop right here now and do a little business with America before we can start this game. This is first things first. This is first.
grand.
Listen, you were all grand. I mean, the audience, not you. No, you were terrific there. You were just grand, yes.
Hello,
and you're going to come back tomorrow and do the same thing, right?
Right.
Okay. Join us mañana for Match Game 75. Goodbye.